Hello, my name is Amy Sturkey. I am a pediatric physical therapist, and I'm doing my series in which I answer questions. So someone asked me, can you describe to me what increased tone is, or high tone, or stiffness, or spasticity, in layman's terms? This is when the muscles are just too tight. And when I mean too tight, it's hard for people to understand what that's like. So the closest I get to high tone is when I'm really nervous about something, when I'm tense. Everybody gets a little tense when you're kind of jumpy. It's that times 20, 30, 50 by a magnitude of something. It's where your muscles are just way too tight. You have difficulty relaxing your muscles, and the muscles themselves, since they're active all the time, often these people have more muscle definition than the typical person. They may get into abnormal postures or positions. For example, often people who have spasticity in their arms, their thumb is often inside their hands, or their hands are closed. They often have their arms tucked. So if you have spasticity on one side of the body, that side tends to be fisted, and you tend to see flexion in the arms, although sometimes it's extended. Most of the time I see flexion. And the legs tend to be straight, brought in toward each other, even crossing each other's, and the toes pointed. That's what the most common way that you see the legs being stiff. Often people think of these muscles, they must be stronger, but the research doesn't back that up. They really have one position that they fire strongly in, and the brain is actively getting messages. The muscle is telling the brain, these muscles aren't tight enough, please tighten it up a little bit more. So they send messages back to the muscles that tighten up. These kids, they like to stand, but they don't like to sit. Because in standing, everything is straight. And if you sit, everything's not straight anymore. You have to bend across that hips. They like everything to be the same. So things like being on your hands and knees, that's a nightmare because everything's bent and some parts straight and some parts bent. Those are hard positions for them. When families tell me, my kid loves to stand, that's all he wants to do, and they're not anywhere near standing age, that's a problem. What is it caused by? Well, in children, it's caused by cerebral palsy, which is caused by not enough oxygen to the brain or a bleed in the brain in the periventricular areas, so in the center of the brain. It can also be caused by a stroke or a blow to the head or a brain tumor or an infection. And then people always want to know, well, how do I get rid of this stiffness? This stiffness is terrible. What will make it go away? Well, gosh, it's also a lifelong condition. It is difficult to get rid of, but the good news is the brain is really able to change, especially in young kids. The brain can change. So what you need to do is help the kid do things, exercise and move using those body parts. You have to find ways to encourage them to move. And babies that have stiff legs, they recommend the kicking protocol of setting up balloons tied to their feet and pianos by their feet and mobiles that are with strings connected to their feet so that when they move their feet, things happen. The more you can make the kid move those legs, the more likely that other areas of the brain are going to take over the part of the brain that's been damaged so those muscles can learn and that brain can learn to move in new ways with new parts of the brains that aren't damaged. So exercise is really important. Stretching has a short-term effect to decrease spasticity or stiffness. Weight bearing through a body part, through a hand that's stiff, through the legs that are stiff, helps reduce the stiffness in the legs. So that's really important. Whole body vibration is something I use personally with clients that have stiffness to help loosen up that tone. I've had a client that once said that if they were in the hot tub every day, then it made a huge difference in their stiffness. You can use splints or bracing to help stretch them out. Really, the standing protocols, 30 to 45 minutes of standing each day can help reduce stiffness. Medication can help decrease stiffness. For example, baclofen, either orally or intrathecally, diazepam or dantrolene or things that are medications that are used to decrease stiffness. They also have surgeries that you can do, which are the selective dorsal rhizotomy. It's another surgery that can be used to decrease stiffness. It's something that you have to find ways to work through. It's just not something that just easily disappears. Some people ask me, can you have a mix of high tone and low tone? Yes, I see this all the time. A lot of times kids are stiff in their arms and their legs, but their trunk is low tone. I can't even duplicate that because when I try really hard to tighten up my arms and tighten up my legs, it's really hard for me not to tighten up my core. But these kids do it, that are really weak in the center, but their arms and legs are really stiff. These are the things I think about when I think about stiffness. It's important if you think your child has stiffness that you go to a doctor soon. You find a physical therapist soon. The earlier you treat stiffness and work it through, the better your child will do. I hope this video is helpful for you to know about spasticity. And in general, I am really enjoying answering questions. If you have a question you want me to answer, feel free to email me at amysturkey@gmail.com. That's amysturkey@gmail.com. I hope this is helpful and I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. If you liked this video and would like to be notified by email when the next video comes out, click the subscribe button here and click the golden bell icon and ensure notifications are enabled on your account.